are here is a place called Turtle Creek, in just outside of Woodstock, New York. Originally, it was a farm, and my former manager bought this property and divided the farmhouse into three apartments. And when the band that I was playing with, Janis Joplin, moved here, we lived here. This was the first place where we lived for quite a while. And this was a barn on the property. There's a deer. And decided to turn this into a recording studio. There's been numerous people who've recorded here. Probably one of the most famous albums that was done here was the Muddy Waters Woodstock album that won a Grammy. But this was primarily a recording studio. Now, over in the farmhouse, which you can't see right now, where a lot of jams or like just get together singing sessions and playing sessions would happen at night. It had a lot of different people, from Van Morrison to Bob Dylan to just everybody who lived here at the time. And it was not only here, but anywhere. It was an impromptu thing. Excuse me for a second. Look at that deer.
Busted flat in Baton Rouge, waiting for a train, and I was feeling near as faded as my jeans. Bobby thumbed a diesel down just before it rained, and rode us all the way into New Orleans. I pulled my harpoon out of my dirty red bandana. I was playing soft while Bobby sang the blues. Windshield wipers slapping time, I was holding Bobby's hand in mine. We sang every song that Javi knew. Freedom is just another word for nothing left to lose. Nothing, I mean nothing, honey, if it ain't free. Me and my Bobby, yeah. From the Kentucky coal mine.
Well, I started playing keyboards when I was 4 years old. I joined my first band when I was 12. And I guess my first paying job was when I was about 13. I used to play in fraternity houses in Toronto, until I got caught as a found-in because I was underage when the police raided it. And then I moved on, played with various bands in Toronto. A lot of bands that people would, probably wouldn't even know by now, but they might. Played with Livingston's Journey, Robbie Lane and the Disciples at the time. Let's see, who else? I say Richie Knight and the Midnighters. I can't think of any other. Anyways, I ultimately ended up playing with Ronnie Hawkins after the Levon and the Hawks left Ronnie. I played with him on and off for a number of years until I got a job to play with Janis Joplin. And I worked with her until she died. And the band that backed her up, we moved here, which is Woodstock, New York. And after that band sort of dismantled, I played with a lot of different people. Paul Butterfield, John Sebastian from A Loving Spoonful, Bonnie Raitt. I'm sure there's some other people I've forgotten. I hope they were seasons, they won't hold against me. After I finished a period here, I moved briefly to Los Angeles and ran a band for a lady named Valerie Carter, who was with Earth, Wind & Fire. Moved to Atlanta, played with my friend Jim Weider, who lives here now. And And we had a band there for quite a while. Then I moved to Alabama and worked with a band down there. Came back to Canada about 1989. And it's about that period I met my friend Colin Linden, who has been very good to me and helped me break down some doors in Toronto. So he introduced me to Bruce Coburn. I played with him for a while. And then after Bruce, I played with Stan Celeste, who replaced Richard Manuel in the band, passed away, I took his chair. And then when Rick Danko died from the band, I've just been pretty well freelancing ever since.
Die. Lift yourself.